Hey guys, it's Cassie.
It's Richie. So today we're gonna be doing a new kind of series. We're not too sure yet. Depending if you guys like this kind of series, it's gonna be called What We Would Wear.
Yeah, so obviously we got this idea from Jen M. She's been doing it. I think she's probably like 12 episodes in or even more. Not quite sure, but I'm pretty sure she started this series on YouTube at least. Correct me if I'm wrong, but a couple of YouTubers have actually also done this series, so we thought we would try it for ourselves. Yeah. And if you guys like it, comment below and maybe we'll do more. So we asked you guys on Instagram to come up with different scenarios or kind of outfit challenges for us to style outfits around and show you guys what we would wear.
By the way, shout out to Princess Polly for partnering with us in this video.
I feel like I need to talk in this Australian accent because they're from Australia.
There it is.
And I'm so sorry if I butcher this at all. I haven't been to Australia in like 2 years, but I'm gonna stop. People are cringing. Anyways, so yeah, this is in partnership with Princess Polly. They're an Australian company. I've never shopped at their website before, but I was super excited to be partnering with them because I really love their stuff. As you can see, this hat is like awesome. I love it. It fits my large head, which is great. This is from Princess Polly, and this, everything is from Princess Polly. And if you guys are interested, they also gave us a coupon code to share with you guys. If you guys want to check out their stuff, what is the coupon code?
It's to the nines for 20% off.
Richie and I decided to do two scenarios together and then two other scenarios like separate. Six scenarios total that you guys came up with. Our first scenario that we're sharing is New Year's Eve outfits because it's almost New Year's. So for my outfit, I picked out this really, really luxe silk like cowl neck dress from Princess Polly. I think it's so pretty and so flattering. I love the cut. I love cowl necks in general because I feel like it's just such a flattering neckline. And I decided to get a size up because with silk, I find that it kind of clings to your body and you don't want to show the, or I didn't want to show the fupa. So I, you know, sized up a little bit and I think it looks really nice. I love the open back. So paired with that, I put on this. Well, it's actually Richie's blazer because I didn't bring mine. So it's this cropped black blazer that she thrifted. I think it was your mom's, right?
No, it's my mom's.
It's Richie's mom's, yeah. And then for shoes, I just went with these beige heels just to kind of pull the look together. I really like it. And if I was going out on New Year's, which I'm not, I don't think. I think it's gonna be at home, right?
At home,
yeah, I would definitely wear this look.
So for my outfit, you guys know how much I like leopard. So I mean, why not wear leopard and silk because obviously it's New Year's. Because the dress is a bit short on me because I'm a little bit taller, I put on my dad's biker jacket, which is really cool. I like to juxtapose like dressy and like really masculine. I also finish it off with my combat booties. I love the whole like dress combat booties kind of like style, so yeah.
I'm gonna take this one on. I am literally wearing something that Richie would wear and I blame it all on Richie because I love this outfit so much. I actually picked it out pretty much all from Princess Polly. When I saw it, I was like, wait a minute, this is totally Richie's style and I'm stealing it, but I love it. So the top is actually a dress. It's kind of like a peasant top and I love the cinching in the arms. And I tucked it into these combat pants, which I thought was really interesting. It definitely juxtaposes the look as Richie loves to do. And I even stole her combat boots. As you can see, Richie and I are filming in Richie's house. Therefore, we're taking from Richie's closet. But I have my own combat boots. It's just
not with us right now.
It's not with us right now. So just imagine those combat boots are mine, I don't know. Pretty much the same anyway. So those combat boots are from Korea and they're so comfortable. I'm so jealous I didn't pick them up.
I wish I bought 10.
Yeah, anyways. Oh, and the belt is from Korea as well.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I didn't really need to do that because I met my boyfriend's parents like 10 years ago.
Also,
it just so happened that we are now dating, so.
And also like her boyfriend's dad, aka my uncle,
is my mentor
and Richie's mentor.
My second dad.
Yeah.
So like I didn't have to re-meet him or like put my best foot forward because he already knows me. But you know, given the scenario, this is probably what I would wear.
Yeah.
So the top's a little bit loose. I wanted to wear like a girlier top because I was just wearing jeans. I didn't want to try too hard, you know?
Yeah.
So I wore baggy jeans with a nice silky top. So you gotta cover up a little bit, add like a bandeau underneath or something.
Or like something that doesn't show your midriff.
Depending. A little bit of midriff is okay, depending on
how conservative the parents are. Yeah. You can dress according to whatever your boyfriend's parents are probably like.
Yeah, whatever
we
they
don't
like.
Know, but Richie's boyfriend's parents happened to be very chill.
But overall, I was myself. I was comfortable, loose clothing. I love loose clothing. Wore something a little bit wild. It's my new boots from Princess Polly, cowboy booties. But
kinda
I like
equestrian.
Yeah, I like these ones because it's not like super loud cowboy. The ones that like go all the way up to like your shins, and this one's a little bit more just like your regular booties, but has like the cowboy detailing. So I really like it.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Wanted to add a little bit of an accent. So I was actually inspired by Dani because she was wearing a snakeskin belt, which is also trending right now. So yeah.
I love wearing beige to church. I usually wear a lot of beige in general, so I decided to put together this little beige ensemble from Princess Polly. So I put on this hat, this blazer that I got from Princess Polly, and I love, love, love how it matches the pants that I thrifted.
Yeah.
I think the whole outfit is really nice and flowy, topped up with the hat and the tank top underneath, just to add a little bit more like
casual-ish
kind of vibe. And then the shoes I decided to wear are Richie Skechers. Yeah, white Skechers. I have white shoes, so pretend they're mine too. And yeah, I really like this fit. It's really cool. Richie said,
"We're both
what?
Whoa,
what?
Jinx, double jinx."
What?
We were both decked out in beige.
Yeah,
if you didn't notice. I'm wearing a jumpsuit, which is probably my favorite pick from Princess Polly. I just love jumpsuits in general. They're just so like easy to wear. Just a disclaimer, our church, we don't really wear suits and ties. We're very casual. We can kind of wear whatever we want.
We actually go to a non-denominational Bible-based church, so it's pretty casual.
Pretty chill. We meet at a theater.
We do.
So it's really cash, not too like dressy.
Would you wear that if you were on stage or just a churchgoer? Oh!
Yeah, I would wear that if I, cause it's, you know what? I figured it's hard to wear dresses as I'm playing the bass.
Yeah.
Cause it kind of looks weird.
Yeah, and you're jumping around.
Which is why I can't be super girly.
Yeah, true. Cause I would wear this fit if I was singing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
If you guys didn't know, Richie plays the bass in our worship team and then I do background vocals. But I'm off for the month because I had laryngitis and my pastor wants me to rest my voice.
Yes.
But my voice is fine now. So maybe next month I'll be singing again.
You're good.
Yeah.
And then for shoes, I wore sock booties just to dress it up. Normally I probably wear like sneakers or whatever just because I'm jumping around with my guitar. But sock booties were nice with it, so yeah.
True. Yeah. Next up, I have late to school, which I probably will be because I'm gonna be back in school next semester. So what would I wear when I'm late to school? I love to just be comfortable and cozy when I go to school. I don't like dressing up too fancy normally. And especially if I'm late, I just like to throw on whatever. So I decided for this outfit to wear a nice cord sweatpant tracksuit kind of thing. I love gray sweats. I love gray on gray in general. And then for my jacket, because my school is up on a mountain, I decided to wear my kind of sleeping bag puffer, oversized, huge jacket just to cover me up and keep me warm. So that is actually from Oakenfort. The sweatpants are thrifted. And then for my shoes, I decided to wear my Yeezys. I don't know, I think it looks good. I think, did you see Kim Kardashian's holiday photo? They were literally all wearing sweatpants, so I kind of got inspiration from that, I guess. But yeah.
So for my last outfit, this one's really interesting. What would you wear if you were a cartoon character? The artist draws you with one outfit. It's perfect because I picked out this like really cute top with butterflies on it and it's blue and it's just like...
Richie was so excited about this butterfly top.
I love it so much. So it's a mesh top, so I had to wear something underneath and I wore white pants with it. And then, my blue heels. I wore blue heels and a yellow bucket hat. I just felt really cute because it was butterflies and it was a yellow hat.
Is it springtime, Richie?
No, but you know what? I've been loving spring colors during winter. My fingers.
Oh, Why am I doing it?
My nails.
Yeah.
But yeah.
And if you guys are artists out there and have the free time to draw Richie in that outfit, please do. I would love to see Richie as a cartoon in that cartoony kind of outfit.
Yeah.
It's so cute. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys got inspiration from the 6 scenarios or outfit challenges.
And if you guys want to see more of this series, let us know in the comments and we'll be happy to do them for you.
Yeah. And also shout out again to Princess Polly for partnering us on this video, and don't forget to use the code TOTHENINES for 20% off your purchase. Mm-hmm.
And don't forget to follow us on our Instagram platforms
at Cassie Masenkai,
at Richie Pamintuan,
and at WeAreToTheNines.
Don't forget to hashtag WeAreToTheNines to be featured.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.
Bye!